Rancher 2.3 is here, and it raises the bar for what a Kubernetes management solution does. You know how everyone is talking about day 2 operations? It's the idea that you installed your cluster on day 1, and that was great. And then you started doing things to make it resilient on day 2, like backing it up and making it secure. That's also great. It was Rancher's focus in version 2.2, and it's all important stuff. Some companies have even gone so far as to rename themselves to highlight how that's their focus in Kubernetes. Rancher doesn't want you to stop there. So in Rancher 2.3, they've made it possible for you to do the things you need to do on day 3, day 4, and every day after that. Those are the things that make your Kubernetes clusters useful for everyone who depends on them. The problem is that Kubernetes is moving into the enterprise faster than people can keep up. I don't want to say it's too hard, but I think we all agree that it could be easier. So how does an organization find the shortest path to the benefits of Kubernetes and the ecosystem around it? First up, Rancher 2.3 ships with an Istio integration. This isn't Rancher's flavor of Istio, this is 100% upstream Istio with the entire installation process done for you behind the scenes. Cluster administrators can install it like an application from the app catalog, and then it can be enabled with automatic sidecar injection on a namespace-by-namespace basis. If you just want a quick look at what it's doing, metrics and data pulled from Grafana and Kiali are embedded directly into the UI. And if you want a deeper dive, full installations of Kiali, Jaeger, and Grafana are only a click away. Next, there's UI integration for horizontal pod autoscaling. This is something that Rancher's enterprise customers have been clamoring for, an easy way to configure their workloads to scale up and down under load without having to drop out to the Kubernetes CLI to do it. Like everything that Rancher does, this front-ends the Kubernetes components that do the heavy lifting, so if you're a power user and you want to get up to your elbows in Kubernetes grease, everything is available for you to tweak and tune. Rancher already integrates with back-end identity providers like Active Directory, Keycloak, Okta, GitHub, and LDAP. Now you can add Google to that list. So if your company uses services from Google Cloud, you can leverage those credentials to control access to the clusters that Rancher manages. Supporting Google for Auth is an awesome addition to Rancher, and another one is the new cluster template feature. This debuts with support for RKE and enables global administrators to define templates for the options available when launching clusters. The options can be selectively enabled for override at launch time, and the templates themselves can be shared in read-only or read-write mode with other Rancher users. Cluster templates are a huge step forward in giving users self-service access to cluster deployment while ensuring that the clusters adhere to the business guidelines from the enterprise IT department. Windows still controls over 85% of the enterprise market, and there's no reason that it should sit on the sidelines while the rest of the world plays kickball on Linux. With Rancher 2.3, you can now deploy Kubernetes clusters with Windows Server 2019. You only need Linux machines for the control plane, etcd, and one worker, and the rest of the farm can be Windows. This isn't some bolted-on afterthought either. Windows nodes are a first-class citizen in RKE clusters, with all workloads going to them by default. Even if you add additional Linux workers, you'll actually have to configure workloads to go to the Linux nodes if you want them to run there. So that means that you can now deploy Windows clusters and just give them to your users. They don't have to do anything special, which means that they can do more and they can do it faster. If you're already running Rancher, upgrade to 2.3 from within the RKE config or by launching a new container that uses the same persistent volume as the current one. If you're new to Rancher, head over to docs.rancher.com and follow the quick start guide to be up and running in under a minute. Come join the community on the Rancher user Slack at slack.rancher.io. I'll see you there.